Hi, this is Daniel from the Ultimate Guitar Academy, and today I'm going to show you three of the most effective exercises you will ever learn on the guitar. Now, the idea behind these three exercises is that they take the three most used shapes for guitar solos, and then we put them on guitar and practice them in different orders. So let's have a look at the first exercise. On the B string, it's 7, 8, 10, and then the E string's exactly the same, 7, 8, 10. Here's what I play. Let's try that again. Now, when you practice this shape, practice it ascending like so. Then, after a while, practice it descending. Then both ascending and descending without doubling up the start or the end notes. And then this really cool pattern where you play a line and then the lowest note on that line goes down a string, like so. And every time you play it, the next note also joins it down a string. Then we play the same kind of idea in reverse, where the front note lifts up a string every time. I'll play that again for you. Then the descending portion. And we're back at the start. So that pattern, when put together a little faster. So in our one shape, we have four different ways of playing it. We have the ascending, descending, both ascending and descending, and then our pattern. Now I'm going to apply those same four patterns to the next two shapes. The first of these shapes is 7, 9, 10 on both the B and the E, like so. So for shape two, we get ascending, descending, ascending and descending, and then our cool pattern from earlier, over and over again. The third shape is going to be 8, 10, 12 on both the B and the high E. So if I play that with the ascending version of the pattern, descending, both ascending and descending, and now with our pattern, so there we have three different shapes, and each shape has four different variations: ascending, descending, both ascending and descending, and then our pattern where we lower one note at a time. I can move these shapes anywhere on the guitar on any string. So I can go down here. I could move up to here. I could go anywhere, I could go up really high. The important thing when practicing these exercises is to make sure you use the right fingers for your left hand. Make sure you're using some kind of alternate picking, either economy or alternate. Because they're only short licks, probably you'll most likely end up in some kind of alternate picking. Now, when practicing these exercises, it's really important to make sure you use the right fingers for your left hand. So for the shape, so for shape one, I'm using index for the 7, middle for the 8, and pinky for the 10, and that's for both strings. For shape two, I'm using index, ring, and pinky for the 7, 9, 10. And then for shape three, this one can go either way, I'm using 8, 10, 12, index, middle, pinky. Some people prefer index, ring, and pinky. I think the stretch from your ring to your pinky is much harder than from your middle to your pinky or from your index to your middle. So the stretch that we get here is easier than the stretch that we'll get here. That's kind of awkward. So I would opt for this, and that's what I recommend everyone plays. However, many guitarists play it the other way with their ring finger on that 10 instead of the middle. Find what's comfortable for you and stick with that. As with any form of exercise or practice, consistency really is the key. If you're practicing it differently every time, you're never going to develop the right skill. We want to practice it the same way every single time so that our fingers learn where to go. The same consistency should apply to my right hand picking. Make sure you're using some kind of alternate or economy style picking for these exercises. Because a lot of them are just three notes on each string, you'll end up most likely with some kind of alternate, down, up, down, up, down, up. If you're like me and you're a bit backwards and you start with an upstroke, which is kind of weird, then you'll be playing up, down, up, down, up, down for many of the exercises. Again, find what's comfortable for you and stick with it. One last recommendation before I let you go, I suggest practicing these completely clean. So no reverb, no delay, no distortion, just guitar into the amp. The idea of this is that we can hear our playing really clearly and we can pick up anything that's not perfectly clean. Another great idea is to have clean day once a week. I used to use Sundays, so every Sunday I wouldn't use any effects whatsoever. Just guitar into the amp, no distortion. Clean channel, that's it. It may also be a good idea to play each of these shapes in each variation for 1 minute every day. So you've got three shapes and four variations, that's 12 minutes per shape. You may not need to go that extreme, you could probably get away with about 1 minute per shape and divide that into 15 seconds on each variation for the shape. So for an example, I'd play the first shape ascending for 15 seconds, then descending for 15 seconds, then ascending and descending for 15 seconds. And then the pattern for 15 seconds. Try to play these non-stop. So as you're playing the first pattern, ascending, and you reach your 15 second mark, instantly switch to the descending so that you're not stopping and then restarting. That's going to develop the most skill. That's it from me. Feel free to visit ultimateguitaracademy.com. I'd love to hear from you through our contact page if you found this lesson useful. Stay cool, and until next time, keep shredding.